Morning, Farmington. I'm Andrew.
And I'm Shay.
Now, we hope everybody had a good break. I know I did.
I did, too. I worked a lot, but I also hung out with my friends.
Hey, Farmington. I hope some of you made some good news resolutions. I know I did. I personally want to be better prepared for college.
I want to have better attendance.
Well, Happy New Year's, Farmington. With the big 2K15 now upon us, it's time for some of those New Year's resolutions into effect. That means all you protein guzzlers and weight junkies out there are going to have some competition at the gym for your favorite spots. Studies show that 12 to 15% of gym enrollment occurs in the weeks around New Year's, with revenue estimated to be over $20 billion. Though, by the first week in February, about 80% of those motivated individuals won't even be there. Studies also show that gym memberships are in the top 10 biggest wastes of money. So if you have a goal of losing a couple pounds before swimsuit season, just keep with it and be part of that 20%.
The interview is a comedy that became the center of a disagreement between the United States and North Korea. It was released in a small number of theaters on Christmas Day after talk of it not being in theaters at all because of the threatened violence against any theater that played it. So Sony left the doors open to video on demand availability at the movie so it could be simultaneously played at your house or you could announce it. So they announced the plans on Tuesday. Michael Layton, Sony Pictures chairman in his studio, was continuing efforts to secure more platforms so that the theaters could play the movie and it could reach the largest audience possible. So after all the fighting, the movie ended up beginning to be possible at your house. You can watch it.
Well, as all of you know, the New Year comes with some New Year's resolutions. Shay has been asking some of the people what their New Year's resolutions are.
Today we're asking people their New Year's resolutions. So what's your New Year's resolution?
So what's your New Year's resolution?
So what's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution is to make varsity on the dance team.
To actually think of a New Year's resolution.
I'd like to make varsity lacrosse.
I don't know, probably get more ripped than I already am, you know.
Probably to be happy and get all my homework done.
That's a good one. What's yours?
Probably to work out every day.
To be on the A honor roll.
So what's your New Year's resolution?
To beat Farmington.
Do you go here?
No.
Where do you go?
Prior Lake. Yeah.
Okay, whoops.
Probably to survive the winter.
I would have to say to work out more.
Get swole. So what's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution is to stop doing stuff. I don't know, it's like stuff like that. I don't know.
That's a good one. So what's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution is to be better than my brother was on Tiger News. Now over to Tristan with the weather.
Hello, Farmington. I'm Tristan McLaughlin here with the weather. I bet you're all wishing you were in New Mexico now with the cold temperatures we're about to be experiencing. Dangerously cold air is plummeting into the single digits, and wind chills are dropping that even more. Throw some snow into the mix and you get a mixture that's really bone-chilling and dangerous, but also really messy. The result? School delays, car accidents, and worries about the homeless. An 18-car pileup in western Pennsylvania has left 2 dead and over 24 injured. School districts, all the way from the south, all the way through the Midwest, have been canceling school days altogether and delaying the starts. Wind chills have been reported down to the single digits and below zero in places like Alabama, North Carolina, and the Midwest. Cities with cold weather in their forecast have been having increasing worries about the homeless. Cities have been moving people with no heat into heated areas, and places in New Jersey have been empowering their law enforcement with the power to move homeless people into shelters and heated areas. Here's the forecast. So today, we're going to be experiencing temperatures of 3 degrees with a low of -2. Tomorrow, it's going to start heating up, and the winds are going to calm down. As we get temperatures of 12 degrees, it's going to start rising. And then Sunday, it's going to keep rising, so we have 16 degrees and -5. And then it's going to start dropping a little bit, and then we get 13-degree weather. And then on Tuesday, it's going to rise back up with 20-degree weather and partly cloudy. One of our directors, Sam, was able to catch up with Justin Hyytinen. Let's check that out.
This week, I caught up with Justin Hyytinen, a cross-country and track runner here at Farmington. Justin has had many successful moments on the track. I asked him what his favorite was.
I've run some pretty good meets. I got third at the state meet in the mile last year. I won the Hamlin Elite meet in a meet record, which is like kind of like a mid-season state meet type thing. But I have to say the thing that I'm most proud of is the culture that we've built up in Farmington over running. Our track team has won the last two conference titles. Our cross-country team has been pretty good. We've sent two runners to state at least every year the past, I want to say, 3 years, or we've had someone at the state meet the last 3 years at least. And it's just kind of growing, and everybody who started out as little sixth and seventh graders are coming up through the program and running really fast.
Track hasn't always been Justin's sport of choice. I asked him what other sports he used to play.
I grew up playing hockey, football, and baseball, and I stopped playing baseball to run track my eighth grade year. And then I quit football to run cross country my sophomore year. And then I stopped playing hockey my junior year to focus more on running. So hockey was my favorite sport growing up, but running obviously is now.
Because of his success in running, Justin is being recruited by many Division I schools.
So the recruiting process was pretty stressful at times, but it was also really fun. And I got to meet a bunch of new people. I was able to take 5 official visits, which is what the NCAA allows. I went to Southern Utah, Northern Iowa, University of Minnesota, the Naval Academy, and then Columbia University. And an official visit is a visit where the schools pay for you to go there. So, for example, when I went to Columbia, they paid for me to fly out there, and then they could pay for a hotel, and then they pay to feed you and entertain you and stuff like that.
Many young kids view Justin as a role model. I asked him what advice he would give to them.
Advice I'd give to aspiring runners is work hard and just do your best. Do the little things right day in and day out, whether that be stretching every day, getting up early and running before school, after school, running in the winter like I am now, and it's minus however many degrees and gets a little brutal, but you got to do it. So get out the door and you'll get better.
That's all for this week, Farmington. Back to you guys in the studio.
Wow, Justin is quite the runner.
Yeah, the whole cross-country team did pretty well this season. As many of you drivers out there have noticed, the gas prices recently have dropped dramatically from prices soaring over $100 per barrel this summer to just under $49. However, experts say it is not possible for the price to drop below $48. This drop is a result of Saudi Arabia attempting to undermine the United States oil production, which is at its highest rate in over 30 years. Though as a result, countries like Russia and Iran, who are major producers of oil, are hurting due to the fact that they simply cannot compete with the prices offered by Saudi Arabia to make a profit. So enjoy these prices while they last, because we really don't know how long they will. Boys hockey team on the couch with Max.
Hello, Farmington. I'm here with Justin Novak and Devin Bernou, here to ask some questions about the season. How long have you two been playing in hockey, and what positions do you play?
I play center. I've been playing since I was about 4.
I play defense, and I've also been playing since I was 4.
Now you had a tournament over break. How did that go?
We won the tournament. We played pretty good, I'd say.
Yeah. It was a strong tournament, and we made some improvements to our team.
You're about halfway through your season. What has been working well, and what could you improve on?
We could improve on our consistency each game, but we've been playing good and working well on our systems.
I think an important thing is everyone's eager to learn and improve, so come to practice and improve their skills.
Okay. Now, boys, you have a new coach this year. How has that been working out?
Very well. They know a lot about the game, and they've improved us as a team.
Before coming to Farmington, he was a coach at Burnsville, which they're also in the South Suburban, so he's brought a lot of South Suburban knowledge to our team.
Now, do you see yourselves at the Excel Center this year?
Of course.
Yeah, that's one of our team goals this year, and that's what we're working to through the whole season.
All right. And then who's your biggest opponent?
Our biggest opponent is obviously Lakeville North, because that's who we're going to have to play to get to the state tournament this year.
Yep. We've lost to him the last 2 years in sections, so they're our biggest rivals right now.
All right. Okay. All right, back to the desk.
So, Jesse, how are sports doing this year?
They're doing pretty good. Basketball recently played. Girls basketball played the Prior Lake Lakers on Tuesday. They were down 41-15 at the end of the first half. The Tigers did better in the second half, but were unable to take the lead, and they fell 64-41. The boys' basketball team was in action earlier this week versus Prior Lake, trying to get their fourth win of the season. Early in the first half, the Tigers' defense will turn into offense as Wyatt Firm with a steal and a two-handed slam. Well, 8 minutes later, Firm again with a steal, and watch him as he goes past the two defenders and throws it down hard with a one-handed jam. The game would go down to the wire. It was tied 57, and the Tigers would have a minute left, and would it be Firm again? No, it's Alex Hart with a nice hook shot for the lead. Without delay, Prior Lake gets on the court, and Connor Bear launches a long three, and it's good at the end of the buzzer. And the Tigers go on defeated 60-59. Wyatt Firm had 30 points on the evening, and every player on the Farmington roster scored, but they came up short. Tonight they will try to bounce back at Lakeville South versus the Cougars. The Farmington Tigers gymnastics team participated in the Faribault Invitational on Saturday. Amanda Davenport had another stellar meet for the Tigers, placing in the top 15 in the three of the four events, and coming in 15th in the all-around with a score of 34-75. Farmington placed 11th with a 129.8 showing. Nice job, girls. Tiger Wrestling had held their own recent meet at home on Saturday. The Tigers won four straight duels, including beating Chatfield 42-33. Chatfield are ranked 8th in Class 1A. Anderson, Gleva, Leduc, Roosted, Venz, and Walls were all undefeated on the day. Tigers are in Bemidji this Saturday. Best of luck, Tigers. The boys' swimming team traveled to the U on Saturday. The team had quite a bit of injuries, but still finished in the top half of the teams. Jonathan Bovey was the only Tiger to receive a gold medal. He scored 208.55 points at the top of 25 divers. Keep it up, boys. J.P. Parisi, former North Star player, and father of Zach Parisi, passed away Thursday morning due to stage 4 lung cancer. He was 73 and was a huge hockey icon for many years. He will be greatly missed, and our thoughts and prayers go out to his family and friends.
Now you all know our game show, You Know Your. We're back with another version this week. Let's take a look at Know Your BFF.
Hi, I'm Caitlin.
And I'm Amelia, and this week on Know Your, we're doing Know Your BFF. We have Destiny and Molly, Abby and Kenzie, and Kayla. Oh, what's their order at Caribou/Starbucks? Flip your boards.
Yeah.
Okay, so Destiny has Caribou, sparkling green tea, lemonade, shot of raspberry, extra sugar.
Yeah.
Gabby has medium campfire mocha. Then we have medium turtle mocha cooler. Yeah.
If they could be on any reality TV show, which reality TV show would it be?
Yes! Real world.
Molly had The Bachelorette. Z had The Real World, so that's wrong. That's not even a reality show.
What is their phone background? So they have me and Molly, a picture of them on New Year's. And then yours is your cousin.
If you guys were real best friends, you'd have each other as your screensaver, but.
And who is funnier? They both have Molly, Gabby, obviously, and Gabby. They both have Kayla.
When you're cuddling with your best friend, who's the big spoon? So Destiny's the big spoon. Gabby is the big spoon when they're, wow, you all got it right.
Who is their lower classman crush? So Destiny has Tyler Wank and Tyler Wank. They both have no one, and then they both have Tanner Stunt.
Stunt?
I don't know, what is it, Stunt it?
What street does your best friend live on?
Cheaters.
Okay, flip your words.
Three.
Okay, that's right. That's right too. Okay, but it's right. So, Molly and Destiny are winners, and you guys can come here and claim your prize. If you watch the show regularly, you would know we usually give out a plaque, but we're poor, so we didn't go to the dollar store and get one. So, you guys get... Are you gonna open it?
Oh. Oh, yes. I guess I was waiting for mine.
I was too.
I
wanted it.
We just wanted to prove to the school that we're better friends than Destiny and Molly, and that's
why we decided to compete in our game after everyone left, because good try, you got second place, but we still won.
Obviously we win because mm-hmm. we're the ultimate
BFFs.
We still won, okay?
We're the winners. Bye.
Wow, those girls sure know a lot about each other.
Yeah, they must be really close.
Let's send it over to Max, who has the girls' hockey team on the couch.
Hello, we're back with the girls' hockey team captains. Can you introduce yourselves?
I'm Michaela Tonsager.
I'm Shelby Klotz.
I'm Maddie Oynes.
How long have you all been in hockey, and what position do you play?
I play center, and I've been in hockey for about 10 years.
I play defense, and I've been playing hockey for about 9.
I play center or wing, and I've been hockey for about 9 years.
And over break, you hosted a tournament. How did that go?
We got second place, and we felt that we played pretty well. We lost to Red Wing, which was a hard loss because we were winning after the first period, but we did well overall.
Okay. Now you're halfway through your season. What has been working well, and what could you improve on?
We've been working well with our lines. I'd say we switch them up a lot to just keep our chemistry going.
Yeah, it's probably just our chemistry that's been working well, and having younger girls with us, it just kind of, we have to focus a little more and work together, and that's been doing pretty well for us.
Yeah, I think the team environment and, again, our chemistry just goes well, and it helps how we play.
All right. Now, this year, who's your biggest opponent?
I would have to say Lakeville South. They're my favorite team to play because I hate them.
Yeah, South by far is our biggest opponent. They're a very good team, and it's good playing with them.
North was fun to play this year too, but definitely South because it's always a good game.
All right. And what are some goals you have for the rest of the year?
We would like to finish above 500 at the end of the year, and we just want to keep working hard in practice and in games.
Probably just staying close with the girls and stuff and working well together.
Yeah. Again, we're one game above 500 right now, so keeping that going and ending the season strong and making our mark in the South Suburban Conference.
All right. And finally, are you happy with the way you have been playing this year?
Yeah, after the tournament especially, we've been playing a lot better, so we're really happy with it.
Like Michaela said, after the tournament, we've just all been working very well together and staying more focused with the game and stuff.
All right. Thank you. Now back to the desk with hashtag selfie.
Last week we introduced our hashtag selfie segment.
We only got a couple, so make sure to send some more in because we need more so we can make a slideshow of them. Every year as the clock nears midnight on December 31st, many people travel to New York City. Anticipation is high for New Year's Eve in New York City. At midnight all around the world, people are full of happiness and cheers as the clock strikes 12. As the famous New Year's Eve ball descends from the flagpole atop Times Square, an estimated 1 million people in Times Square, millions nationwide, and over a billion watching throughout the world are united in a collective farewell to the departing year. While they express joy and hope for the new year ahead, the Times Square New Year's Eve celebration features the star-studded musical performances, balloons, and about a million of your closest friends. Well, I'm Shay.
I'm Andrew.
I'm Tristan.
I'm Jesse.
And don't forget, seniors, to get your seniors' pictures into Miss Truinka by this Friday at room 1403.
Today we leave you with the dance team's performance from Tuesday night. Have a good weekend, Farmington.